empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football, and they've got it here with a first down. Now it's Breida. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite an excellent display of footwork. In on the stop, it was the UCF product, Shaquem Griffin.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now Garoppolo throwing on second. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. They'll get a couple yards on that one. And just like that, it's third down. Throw. It's Garoppolo. Now he'll let it go deep left side. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Shaquem Griffin with a pick. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
Forced out to his left. Now he'll throw, looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. They were looking for Johnson that time.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and the receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Gotta know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Slant gets exactly 10, and by the nose of the football, they've got a first down.
Here we go, hurry up, hurry up! 12, 12, 6, 6.
Garoppolo on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Grant, and he'll get it down this time to the 17. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
There's Garoppolo to throw, buying time to his left. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. And it's caught. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Jerick McKinnon with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Niners are able to cash in for six. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And it's now 17-14. Gold now out to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here come the Seahawks now set to take over on offense. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. It's a big hook up there. Wilson to Baldwin. 48 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. A first down carry here for Johnson. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. Second down, here's Wilson. Looking left side, it's complete, he's got it. The result, a first down as a quick slant gets him 14. First down now, but that clock rolling.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal. Second and goal from inside the 5. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Flushed out right. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So third and goal, and the 49er faithful making some noise for their defense. They'll run it with Johnson. And he's across the chalk, into the end zone, touchdown Seahawks. Duke Johnson, his first touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks are able to strike for 6. And he knocks it through. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Set to return. Here's Raheem Mostert. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down.
There, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
The Niners on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and five. Shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And that's complete to Kraft. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as he'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Garoppolo now hitting on 80% of his passes in the early going. 8 of 10. It's first down. To throw once more. He's going to float this one deep right side. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Back to the air on second. It's Garoppolo. Wide open receiver complete. A big play there just before halftime. 52 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. A great effort there as the first half is winding down. And the Niners are able to cash in for six. Gold with the extra point, and that gives him a 3-point lead. Gold now out to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Clock at 20 seconds to go in the half as they come up first and 10. They go play action here on first down. Baldwin with it over the middle. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as he'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Wilson to throw again. He lets it fly for Lockett. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. The Seahawks on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. Final play of the half. It's Wilson escaping the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you eastward to Orlando. Standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and 3. On second down, Johnson, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Wilson now to throw on third down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Wilson now 9 of 17 through the air. Not a great percentage, but it is first and 10. They go play action with Wilson. And that is incomplete.
The frustration is definitely setting in because they've thrown it to him over and over, unable to come up with a catch thus far.
I think he knew he would have his challenges against his secondary. I don't think he saw a goose egg at this point in the game. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. And his pass, incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that, and thus far they've been successful.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. He finds his man, Baldwin, and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. They're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On first down, Wilson. He sets to fire deep. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. They give him a gain of 37. Well, it's one thing to grab it with one hand, but when you make a catch of that distance, quite another.
Yes, sir. I mean, that one right there, we keep talking about the high-flying antics that we're seeing from receivers nowadays. Doesn't matter what spot they start in. But when it actually does happen in the heat of battle, brings me right out of my seat.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try to run with Carson. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense. Countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Now it's Wilson. And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
So third and goal, and the 49er faithful making some noise for their defense. From the shotgun, Wilson. Flush to his right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, it's been a tough go for him. These guys have been driving down the field, but defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure, that's going to lead to a fourth down. Well played.
So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone, get you 6?
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 26. There's Garoppolo on first and 10. Throw left side complete. It's Grant. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On second down, here's Garoppolo. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Throwing now is Garoppolo. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow, ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They go play action now. Wilson. He's got a man. That's caught left sideline. That one goes for 24 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Now a play fake here on first down. Flushed out right. Incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43.
Tempo, tempo.
Second and 10. It's Wilson again. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. Here's Wilson. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. 23 yards on the play. So from inside Niner territory now, this is 1st and 10 as they're down to the 29-yard line. Wilson will throw again. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. To throw again, Wilson. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Back now here in Santa Clara. All even as we get ready to start the 4th. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on 1st and 10. Now Wilson, escaping the pressure right. And his throw is incomplete. The intended target, Doug Baldwin. That'll bring up 2nd down. A little too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down.
Tempo, tempo.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Steps away to his left. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down. This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10.
Gotta go.
Throwing again here, Wilson.
being chased out left. This is caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They come out here in the eye. Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. They only get a hard-fought yard, but that's all they needed. It pays off, the decision to go for it, first and goal. A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. They run it with Carson, and he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 of the year. And the Seahawks are going to take the lead. And he's got it up and through. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Well, they had to run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Now Garoppolo throwing on second. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. The Niners on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. This is Breida. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. That'll be good for 6, but now it's fourth down.
I think we can safely say that those types of players are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Garoppolo, gotta have this one. And the grab by Croft. And they're gonna have this across midfield and inside the 45. That pickup goes for 25. What a flip of the script. From fourth down to first. Garoppolo looks to throw. His throw incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
White. 13.
Garoppolo again here on second and 10. And this one's incomplete. Tyler Croft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. And it's third down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
30-yard play on third.
you have to give some credit because he broke some tackles in order to get that big pickup. But maybe it's a little bit more that the lost art of tackling reared its ugly head on that play. And the end result, a big-time pickup of yardage.
Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. This will be caught just inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
21.
And yet again, it's Garoppolo. And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Tyler Croft, his first touchdown on the year. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This will be taken very short. And some good coverage there by the kick team as they'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. And out now come the Seahawks. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are. But with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
They begin the drive with Johnson, and he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be, but we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
On second down, here's Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Foot left, foot left. Put the team.
Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
On first down, Garoppolo. Now they go screen. It's complete. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. They'll get 4 there out of the screen, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
12, 11.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Check the press.
From the gun on third, Garoppolo. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more.
11, 11. White, white, white. 21, 21. Here we go. Hey, by 50, by 50. By
50. So that'll back him up five. Here's Bradley Pinion now, standing just outside his own goal line. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Wilson to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Well, that's a good first step, but several steps still to go.
They still have time for the possible game-winning field goal. Time for them to be quick and hurry at the same time.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Here's Wilson. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively, as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Start! They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. And the 49ers going to take another timeout as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. And the Seahawks on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This will be third and six. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down.
This has been an up-and-down, back-and-forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. He hasn't missed a kick all year. Why would he start now?
That's a great question, isn't it? Well, maybe because that was the most nerve-wracking kick he had to attempt all year, but he knocked it through just like it was an easy chip shot.
The 49ers offense making its way back out there. Look at the clock. Everyone knows the situation. Probably time here for one final play.
And we know what that play is going to be. It's got to be some sort of Hail Mary, throwing it towards the end zone and hoping someone can catch it or catch it off of a tip. Think back to 2015. Didn't we see Green Bay pull that off twice in the season? Once in the regular season, once in the playoffs. So stranger things have happened. It'd be interesting to see what the defensive strategy is about who they put on the field to try and knock that ball away.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still... You're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Seahawks, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0 on the new campaign. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Washington Redskins. Meanwhile, for San Francisco, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Arizona Cardinals. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
the system. Hoping I ain't lose religion. Text and prayer hands. Hope the message sending. Know I've been blessed. I've been seeing prophets. Bust the yellow shirts. Louder than the rock. Me dancing in my chucks. Everybody say the same man. Got me. Can you hear me? Spitting too much drive, need some power steering, cruising to a better vision, y'all. Can you hear me?
Seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life and they can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
When you got dumb cake up in the say that they be waiting.